and welcome to Chair Interval Training, brought to you by Community Access Yellow Springs and the Yellow Springs Senior Center. And me, all alone here in this exercise studio, Lynn Hardman, Silver Sneakers Flex Instructor. But as always, you don't have to be a Senior Center member or a Silver Sneakers member to get the benefits of exercise. I am proud to be a happy citizen of this local village, and I enjoyed the Pride Parade that occurred yesterday so much. Thank you for that, and thank you to our local leaders and the whole community for fighting to combat racism, fighting to combat the coronavirus. We love to see you with your mask on here in Yellow Springs, and fighting for the rights of LGBTQ folks and everyone. So let's stay strong with our exercise program. Now, I don't need my mask, I'm alone in this little studio, but I will need a jug. Today I have here, and many of us in Yellow Springs may own a gallon jug of vinegar. It could be up to 8 pounds of resistance for our strength training. If it's full of water or vinegar with the lids tightly on, but you could use a smaller jug. And you could use, well, half full would be 4 pounds and a quarter full would be 2, so do the math. But before you start this exercise program, get your jug, screw the lid on tight, make sure you got some water, and consult your physician before you do any exercise program. We want to keep it safe, and if you feel dizzy or out of balance at any time, remain in your chair or return to your chair. All right? We're going to use a little music. We're going to be standing up, sitting down. I'm trusting you to trust your body, and if you feel like something hurts, don't do it. All right? Here we go. All right, whether you're seated or standing, you want your best posture. By elongating your spine, you make it easier to breathe and easier to move. So you can move in your chair, or you can come to your feet. It's your choice. Dig those heels in if you're standing. And this is a good time to check the area around your chair. Make sure there's nothing you can slip, trip, or fall on, and always stay within reach of your chair. We can just march it out and start to explore our full, safe, comfortable range of motion. Best posture with your ears over your shoulders, over your hips, and a nice deep inhale. See how our shoulders feel today? If some part of the range of motion hurts, so just shorten the range of motion, reduce it, or go back to the last thing you did that felt good to you. I want you to always be within reach of your chair so you can use it as your assistive device. I'm going to scooch over here to the left so you can see my feet. I want to preview a couple patterns. We always work on the ABCs in our chair interval training classes. A is for agility, B is for balance, C is for coordination. Research proves that this is one way to improve our quality of living and reduce our risk of falls. That's what it's all about. Anyway, here is our agility pattern. It's simply going to be a marching pattern. Now, if you're over on the side of your chair, you'll have room to do it in, touch the chair, but it's an out, out, in. We do this pattern a lot, but today we're going to do it a little bit differently. I'm kind of making it into a V step. And I want you to stay right there where you can touch your chair, but I'm going to come a little bit closer in front of my chair so you can see what I'm doing with my feet. So you stay there, but I'm moving. Okay, so I'm making a V step. Can you see that? A little bit forward, right, left, or left, right. Well, let's make it even more challenging by making it into an X step. Imagine the big letter X on the ground, and we're just stepping on the tops of the letter X, and then coming back to the center. Well, I want you to take it to the bottoms of the X. So top of the X, bottom of the X. Essentially, it's like 5 points that we're stepping on. Later on, we'll do it even faster, if you feel like it. But just mark it out. Got that blood circulating. That's what the warm-up's all about, is to just get your systems ready for a little more work. So, we've got that pattern in our mind. Here's another one as we continue to warm up. It's called two and two. We've done it before, but it never hurts to rehearse. We're gonna take two slow steps to the right behind our chair, always within reach, and then two little lifts on the right, and then two steps to the left. Two left lifts. So we can touch our chair while we do that. Tap our toe down for our balance check if we need. We're going slow. If we move a little bit faster, here's what it looks like. Two to the right, two lifts. Two to the left, two lifts. We can do other kinds of lifts. This is a knee lift. What if we do toe raises and lift our body up, up? Warming up those calves, thighs and hips. Reaching overhead if it feels good. Let's try two more and then we're gonna get a little bitty calf stretch. Little bitty. Good, how are you doing? March that right foot, left foot, either foot will do. Back and pace the heel on the ground and lean forward. Good, pull up to the ball of the foot. Balance your shoulders over your hips. Tuck your pelvis under and open your spine. Close, open. Got our chair if we need it, but if we don't, we can take it to both arms. Excellent. Let's try that with the other leg. I didn't even try to say right or left that time. Paste your heel on the ground with that other leg. You know which one you started with. I can't really tell. Leaning forward for that gentle calf stretch. Now, pull up to the ball of that rear foot if you can. Sometimes arthritis in the toe joint really prevents that, but whether you're on your flat foot or the ball of your rear foot, curl, tucking your pelvis under to get a little stretch here on the hip flexor. And again, if your balance is rock steady, you could take it to both arms. We're gonna continue warming up, but we're gonna transfer to our chair with our ever so useful body weight strength exercise. Yes, we do squat in this exercise class. Heels close to the chair for safety. That way if your knee buckles or you lose your balance, you're gonna land safely in a seat. Otherwise, keep your weight equal in both feet. Try not to let your knees knock. Keep your head up. Spotting a point across the room really helps. And get settled in your seat, kind of near the front edge of the chair. Whenever we're sitting down and you feel thirsty, do help yourself to a sip of water. But it's best to keep your head above the level of your heart so you don't get dizzy and step to the side, brace with your abdominals and your arm and lean to the side. Well, Okay. Sitting tall, let's do a little shoulder roll. Pulling them up towards our ears, back, and then down and smooth it out. Forward, up, back, down. You can take it into your arms or just into your elbows. And see if you can, well, just use it or lose it with your range of motion. If it hurts though, back off, make it smaller. Let's stretch out our right leg, supporting our body on that left lat. Inhale up. Good, and hinge halfway forward to that lat, supported there. Reach forward, stretch your tailbone back. Lift your toes and fingers up. Feel the stretch develop, and then down. Excellent. Sitting tall, let's stretch out that other leg. We've got to keep moving right here in our chair. We can do that. Hinging forward. Reaching forward. Lifting the toes and the fingers up. And then pushing them down. Good. Okay. Sit tall and push your right leg out. And push your left leg out. And if it feels good, show me the sole of your shoe. Hold up, navel in, strong, like you're zipping up tight pants. Good, let's take both arms and kind of reach for the toes. You don't have to touch. Good. I hope it feels good. If it doesn't, go back to the last thing that didn't hurt. Okay. Let's see if we can get a little bit of a flex going. Flex point. That didn't work at all, did it? You know what? Let's just skip that part today. Special. All right. To get ready to move a little bit more, I want you to pay attention to your breathing and your exertion level. On a scale of 1 being the lowest exertion level or the least intense, and 10 being the maximal intensity, how are you feeling right now? Remember, our target is a 4 to a 7. Whether we're in our chair or standing in the air, you're in control of you, so we're about to get started. We're going to shoot for a 10-minute chunk, if you would, of continual aerobic movement to strengthen our heart and our lungs. And anytime we do that, we strengthen our brain as well. We're gonna do our 2 and 2 pattern that I showed you, but you can do it in your chair. So let's go to the right, slow. And then lift that right knee twice. If you're choosing to stand, you're gonna carefully get up out of your chair and get behind your chair and double check that area to make sure there's nothing under your feet that will cause you to slip, trip, or fall. So we could do it slow in our chair, or we can go a little faster. You ready? 2 steps right, 2 right knees. 2 steps left, 2 left knees. Now, if you're in your chair, you will notice your thighs, especially the quadriceps and the hip flexors, get a little sore. So you're going to have to be creative, maybe pull your heels back or stretch your heel out. But just keep moving. It's so good for you. And it gets easier if you keep at it regularly. Now, I'm going to transition to my feet, but I need you to keep moving out there. Okay, keep moving. I'm going to get behind my chair. So, remember, don't wander away too far from that chair. Best posture, and we'll take 2 steps over and 2 lifts of the knee. 2 steps over and 2. Now, while we're lifting the knee, we're balancing. But we know we can touch the chair. And we also, if we need to, can tap our toe down. This is a balance pattern, but it does require a little agility and coordination too. That's a good thing. Let's go back to those toe raises. Get up on the balls of your feet as if you're jumping. And if you wanted to make this more athletic, when we go across, you can get low. And when we're on the sides, you can get up high. Down low, up high. This is a good pattern because you can make it as little or as big as you like. Good, so we've done knees and toes. What else could we do here? We can kick our heels up into a hamstring curl. Two on the left. Two on the right. Keep your head high. Awesome. Instead of hamstring curls, we could do hip abduction and just straighten out that leg. Straighten up the spine. Pull the navel in and strengthen those hips. Good. I kind of messed up there. But I'm safe because I've got my chair. Ooh, my hips are starting to feel it. Come on, we'll do one more. And then let's take a little break and assess our intensity. How are you feeling as you march it out? One would be, I'm good to go. I could run a marathon. And 10 would be like, oh, I feel like I just ran one. Are you in that zone of a 4 to a 7? 4 would be, I feel good. I can tell I'm exercising, but I can do a lot more. And 7 would be like, oh, I can tell I'm exercising, but I'm not sure how much more I can do. It's good to be in that 4 to 7, but it's also good to just move at a level 1, not at a level 10. All right? Let's change our pattern up and keep it going. Reminder, you can come to your chair anytime you want. Let's double down. Let's go from 2 to 4. We'll do 4 little steps. And then 4 knees. Yeah? 4 little steps. Now don't go too far. Your steps can go low. And your knees can be a little stippity. But however you do them at your own pace. And don't wander away from your chair. That's pretty challenging. 4, 3, 2. Yeah. 4, 3, 2. Good. Now, if your thighs are getting a little sore, let's try with our toe raises. Up on the balls of our feet. And over. 4, 3, 2. Up. 4, 3, 2. Over. I like this pattern. It can be very aerobic, and that's a good thing. Research shows that if we can try to get 10-minute chunks of activity, that goes a long way towards our heart health. So that's what we're kind of shooting for. Let's try those hamstring curls instead of the toe lifts. So kick your heels up, check your chair. 4, 3, 2. Other side, kick your butt. Sort of. And lift your chest, best posture. 4, 3, 2. It's getting warm in my basement studio. 4, 3, 2. Good. How are you doing? Can you talk? The talk test is a very good way to gauge your proper intensity. Let's try straightening out the leg on this side of those hips. Open it out. 4, 3, 2. Other way. 4, 3, 2. Awesome. Pull the navel in. Let's try one more, and then we're going to really mix it up and try knees, toes, hamstrings, and hips. Here we go. Knees, toes, hamstring, hip. Whoa. Knees, toes, knees, toes, hamstring, hip. Are you with me? Knees, toes, hamstrings, hips. That's our brain game. Last one, knees, toes. My brain went to sleep. Woo, that was about 10 minutes of cardio. Yay! We're gonna transition to our strength work, beginning with our squats. So do squat safely. Get your lower legs and feet right near the chair. This gives us a nice wide base to use more thighs, more hips. Coming down slow and low, and then up with a little power or speed if it doesn't hurt. All right, you can do one or more, it's up to you, but take your time, and once you're seated, please get a sip of water, and please be mindful. Stepping to the side, leaning to the side, it's kinder and gentler to your lower back. All right, we're gonna get to utilize our new strength tool. We're gonna do a whole body exercise. Again, make sure the lid's on tight. We don't want to have a slippery floor. And if you're using a bleach bottle, don't use that in case you do have a spill. It could burn your skin. Vinegar wouldn't. Water wouldn't, obviously. Milk would go bad. But you could always rinse out those containers and save them. And you could have two. And you could see over the course of July, we're going to use this the whole month of July. Plus a couple other things, but you can see that you're getting stronger if by the end of the month you can do a whole gallon of weight. All right, let's get started. We're gonna turn our bodies to the side. So my left leg is back, my right leg is forward. I'm gonna hold the jug in my left hand. I'm gonna keep my right hand on the chair, on the back of the chair. Because if you choose to add a lunge to this movement, you want to have the chair for your balance check, okay? So you can put your foot flat on the ground if you're not gonna do a lunge, but if you are, set it up behind you, tucked under or turned out. Now we're going to keep the spine long and strong as we lean forward, pull the navel in, and row. Breathe each time. Keep your back long and strong and stable. Try not to dip with it, okay? Keep it just straight and strong. Good. Now, if you wanted to, you can add that lunge. I've got the chair for balance there. And that's a good thing. So this is a total body exercise. And we've already done about 14 rows. I'm gonna finish off with two more. And get settled. Now, if you didn't make it all the way through that set, that's fine. We're gonna do another set on the other side, but in between, let's strengthen. That was for our upper back and shoulder, rear shoulder, as well as our thighs and our hips. Let's focus on the core and the fronts of the shoulders and the chest and the triceps a little. With our ab slides, just keep your feet together, slightly ahead of your knees, sitting at the edge of your chair. And pull the navel in, just leave the jug on your lap for now. Slide back, and forward. We've done these before. Join in, pull that navel in, tuck the pelvis under, tuck the lower back. Tuck the chin a little too, and breathe each time. Now, if you want to make this harder, hold the jug close to your body, not resting on your lap. Or you could hold the jug right near your heart and press. You guys keep working. I'm going to show you what that looks like from the side. I just really want to show off my rainbow tie-dye. So, tucking the pelvis under, leaning back, sliding forward, but not all the way up, and then adding our chest and shoulder press. That's a hard exercise. It should be a little challenging, otherwise it can't change us. Do your best, maybe four more. Breathing, pulling the navel in. Oh, that was hard for me. How about you? You can take a break whenever you need. This thing is just sticking to my legs today. We're going to finish off with a one-armed row facing the other way. But there's no rule that says you have to do the left equal to the right or vice versa. If you have pain, don't do it, okay? Otherwise, get set up for safety and success. Getting that right foot back should you choose the lunge. Holding with your left hand the back of your chair. Lengthening your spine. Reaching with the left arm toward the left toes. Leaning slightly forward. Lock in your torso by bracing with your abdominals and breathing. Each time you row is a good time to exhale. Or inhale. Breathe and move at your own pace. And if you're ready, you can add that lunge. Go at your own pace. I was shooting for 16 total reps, so I think I've got about four more of these. But you don't have to do 16. You should feel done. However, when you get to the end of a strength exercise, you should feel like, oh, maybe an 8, 9, 10. That's okay so long as there's no pain. Let's get a sip of water. Step to the side, lean to the side. Okay. We've got time to do that next pattern that I previewed during the warm-up. I called it the letter X. Let's review it in our chair, if you wish. But if you know you're going to be standing with it, go ahead and situate yourself over here on the right side of your chair, please. Able to touch the chair. Best posture, whether you're seated or standing. And if you are seated, you really have to come to the edge of your chair to allow your hips to move through their full, safe, comfortable range of motion. We're going to step out to the right, step out to the left, step in. Do it slow one more time and kind of step forward like the top of that letter X. Just the top half of the X now. Slow. Slow. This part you might know as a V-step. Now, a little faster. Out, out. Together, together. Good. One more. Slow. And then we'll go to tempo. You ready? Here we go. Right, left. Out, out. In, in. Sometimes saying it out loud helps with new patterns. You don't have to do that with your arms if you don't like. You can just swing them in this cross crawl fashion. How are you folks doing who are on your feet? Got it? It's harder to show this pattern seated, but sometimes I have to prove it to myself that I can get my heart rate up and do good exercise in a chair, because you never know. One day I might be temporarily or permanently there. And I am going to be prepared, not scared. Out, out, in, in. Now, whether you're standing or seated, you can do this fast or slow. You can just try that fast. Or faster even. Take a little break. I'm going to transition to standing. You can remain in your chair or return to your chair. Well, let's try it on the left side. And make sure you can touch your chair. Nothing's on your feet. We're going to go left, out, right, out, in, and back. And now bottom half of the X. Left, right, and then the middle of the X. Top half of the X. Out, out, in, in. Bottom half of the X. Out, out, in. Let's try it a little bit faster. Out, out, in, in. Bottom half of the X. One more complete letter X at this speed. Now a tempo. Out, out, in, in. Back, down. Got it? Are you making that X? You can count it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It takes 8 steps to complete the letter X with your feet. If you don't get this pattern, don't worry. We're going to keep working on it. Can you see and touch your chair with your peripheral vision or your fingertips? One thing I notice about wearing a mask, is it does reduce our peripheral vision a little bit. So you have to move your head sometimes a bit more to see the floor. Whatever you do, do it at your own pace and keep it safe and simple. I'm going to go a little faster. You're welcome to try it if you like. It gets harder when we go fast on that letter X. Woo! I'm trying to make that look like an X. How's that working? Not too clear. Relax. Take a breather. Take a break. Time to assess our exertion level, 1 to 10. Where are we now? Can you talk? I wish I could hear your beautiful voice. I wish I could hear all your voices. But let's keep working on this pattern one more time, if you please. We're going to check our posture. Go at our own pace. Make sure you can touch the chair. And try that X pattern with the right lead. Left, and back to the middle of the letter X, and then to the bottom, right, left, good, in, a little bit faster, out, out, wait, did I go faster, out, out, to tempo, out, out, in, in. That's our coordination. See if you can move your arms up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. And just for safety, check your chair. Up, up, down, check. Up, up, down, check. Hey, that's fun. Can we do it faster? Whoop, whoop. Or just run. Run, run, run until you reach the finish line. Slow down if you have to. Walk if you've got to. Crawl. But we're going to make it to that finish line. We're not going to give up. Okay, I think we're going to take a little balance break here before we return to our chair. Keep that heart pumping, but slow it down a little. Remember our personal balance beam or tightrope? We must always be able to touch the chair. Create an imaginary balance beam of your own to perform your best balancing act. Toe heel walks, looking out, using the chair or using the wall until you can't touch the chair anymore. And then, best posture, try going back. I would never do the backward walk without an assistive device. Some of the worst falls are backward falls. So we're just slowing our heart rate down a little bit, but doing some relevant balance work before we return to our chair and return to our strength work. Let's see if we can freeze here on one foot. And extend the leg out, squeezing the hip. Extend the body up. Got our chair if we need a balance check. And look around if you want to challenge your balance more. And then let's do the other leg. Right here where we are. Pull the navel in, stretch the crown of your head up. If your shoulder aches, bring it in. But lengthen that leg and squeeze your glutes. That was good. Time to transition to our strength exercises. Another set. So our best strength work is with our body weight is a squat. Do you know what else you could do? You could use your jog and hold it near your body as you squat, getting your hips back and then tucking them under. We could do our own version of a really good exercise that helps strengthen the heart and the entire posterior chain. We could do our version of a kettlebell swing. Easy does it. Jug goes down, head stays up, jug comes up, butt gets tucked under. Push through your heels, push your knees back, and drive your hips forward, strengthening our shoulders as well. If it doesn't hurt, if it hurts, you're gonna bring it in. And when you're done, have a seat. Don't drink your vinegar, but do help yourself to a sip of water. Oh. All right, we're going to do some, a version of a deadlift, which is a very good, useful, functional exercise that strengthens the hips, the back, and the hamstrings. I'll show you a seated version, and then for those of you who are able, we'll do a second set standing, okay? So let's get our jog. We're going to start with just a bicep curl. Get your feet together, sitting near the edge of your seat, and keep your upper arm pasted on your body, and keep the shoulder down. If it starts to hunch, that's not good for the shoulder, okay? So keep the back long and strong as you lower the jug, but don't hang, and lift the jug. Breathing each time. We're only going to do about 8 to 12 on the right, and then we'll do the left. Actually, before we go to the left, we're going to do a different exercise. Wrap that jug near your shoulder, and keep it near your shoulder as you lift your elbow out, side lateral raise. If that's easy, I want you to hold the jug away from your shoulder only an inch or two. And then it gets ultimately harder Side lateral raise is strengthening those deltoids. That was enough for me. That's hard. Remember, if it hurts, keep it closer to your shoulder. Let's do the bicep curl side lateral raise on the left. Just paste your upper arm to your torso. Down, but don't hang. You're just hanging there. You're transferring the weight-bearing activity to your bones. We want to keep it in our muscles, which in turn strengthen our bones. Breathe. I'm going to do two more. Be mindful and stop when you need a break. And then I'm going to set up for those side lateral raises. I'm checking my lid to make sure it's okay. So sitting tall, it's like a chicken wing. Keeping the jaw mindfully close to your shoulder. If you have the ability to move the jaw slightly away, it's almost like you're pouring. That's why I checked the lid. So we're strengthening a whole bunch of muscles here, but main muscle is the deltoids. All right, so that was the seated version. For those of you who want to stay seated, you're right. But for those who want to stand and work on balance at the same time and hip strength, here's where we're going. To the right side. Set up for safety and success, best posture. Jugs in your right hand. We're going to keep our weight in our right foot. And we're going to take our left foot and paste your upper arm to your body. Take your left foot back behind and just put your kickstand down. So here's what I'm doing with that left foot. Okay? Now, we're going to just do our bicep curl with the head tall, posture erect, a couple times. Then we're going to keep that right leg straight and we're going to hinge at the hip as we come up. Keep the arm pasted into the body. So you look kind of like a dippy bird. You should feel this if you're keeping, you're letting your tailbone go back as you hinge at the hip. Keep your back long. You can lift that rear foot. Kind of look at the floor, but keep your back long and strong. Got our hand right there, a millimeter away from our chair. You should feel this in the hamstring of that right leg. And here's what it looks like from this side. Back long and strong. Okay? All right, moving on. Put your weight in your left foot. Those of you who are seated, we're about to do those side lateral raises. Keep the jaw close to your right shoulder. Lift like you're pouring. Keeping the jaw closer to your body, you can add that. Hip abduction. Ooh, this is a biggie. It's not going to take many more than about 8 for me. My jaw is about, it's at about probably 6, 5.5 pounds today. Whew. How are you doing? If you are out of gas, take a break. If you're seated, we're going to do the left. If you're standing, we're going to do the left. Set yourself up, able to touch the chair, best posture. Weight is now on your left leg. All your weight is there. Pull your navel in and reach your right foot back. Put it down in a kickstand. So maybe only 10% of your weight or less is there. And paste your upper arm to your body. Get your bicep curl going. This is a brand new exercise. And when you're ready, you can add your hip hinge. So back is long and strong. You're squeezing your hips forward. Think of how when you hinge, your back is staying long and strong like a plank. Okay. You can put your foot down anytime you want. You can stop anytime you want. I'm gonna stop now. Okay, last standing exercise. I'm sweating. If you're not sweating, that doesn't mean you're not working. You might have better air conditioning than I do. So this is our side lateral raise. Should sort of feel like you're pouring, but make sure your cap's on strong and tight. And if you like, add your hip abduction. Man, this is a challenging exercise. We'll definitely do this again later in the month of July. When this show airs, it'll be the last day of Pride Month, June 30th, and then again on July 1st. But we're going to be using our handheld weights for the whole month of July, but I will bring back in the ball and or the band at times. So keep those things handy. Hey, let's get seated. And if you want, you can do your last set of kettlebell swings, but keep your back long and strong. Get your hips back. When your hips go down, so does your jaw. And then up. Down slow. Up. Dig your heels in. I don't know why this is so funny. But I guess I never thought I'd be teaching folks exercise on TV or their computer or their smartphone. And I never thought I'd be doing kettlebell swings with vinegar. Well, good news, we're almost through this exercise hour. And it's a great time to get a sip of water. I'm going to check where we're at with our music here. Wherever we are, here we are. Okay, so here's to your health. I hope to keep exercising with you for a long, strong time. Because we're going to need stamina to get through this thing. And remember, when you come to Yellow Springs or when you're out and about and not in your own safe home with your own safe loved ones that you're interacting with daily, wear that superhero mask, would you? Right, if we all do it, it's going to help us get through this time period with much less suffering and death. All right, let's take a deep, deep, deep breath and try to slow our heart rate down. Inhale through your nose if you can. Exhale through your mouth or your nose. Breathe at your own pace. Couple mindful breaths before we start to stretch. All right, well, I'm gonna slow that music down. And I'm gonna invite you to turn your body sideways in your chair. This time, we're not going to do our one-arm rows and our lunges, though. We're going to focus on supporting our spine as we hinge forward to get that left leg back. Take your time with this one. You can have the toe and the whole foot relaxed with the toe back, or you can have it tucked under, but relax it. And also, let the weight of that left knee drift down as you let crown your head drift up. From here, if you like, you can lift the arm. If it hurts, shorten that, soothe it. And if it feels good, you can open your spine a bit. a deep belly breath. Enjoy that stretch developing as your lungs expand. And if you like, exhale and lean towards your chair. Take a deep belly breath here. Ah, that feels good. Ease out. And we'll get the other side. But in between, let's get a little chest opener, spine closer, slow matching our movements with our breath. In yoga, we call this a cow. As we inhale, opening our spine to a gentle arch, lifting our heart, and then a cat. As we close our spine, and have a slightly arched back. Do that again at your own rhythm, at your own pace. That's good. All right. Turning the other way. Take your time. I like to support my back with lengthening through the spine and using my hand as a hinge forward to help that right leg go back. But you know you, do it however works best for you. This is one beauty of home exercise. Nobody needs to see you doing it. I'm sure you look awesome. I know you do. You are awesome. Let your right knee drift down. Feel the weight lengthening that hip flexor, quadricep. Inhale if your shoulder permits, raising that arm. Maybe a little bit of an opening in the spine, but maybe not. And then exhale, stretching through that right side of your body. Enjoy a big, deep belly breath here. Your lungs extend beyond the rib cage, and we really want to utilize all or exercise all of our lungs capacity. Whew, okay, well, let's stretch out our hamstrings one more time, just as we did in the beginning. Now it's good to have your knee right on top of your ankle. Okay. Extend the arm or not, or just hang out here, but really kind of reach your tailbone back and lengthen each and every vertebrae of your spine on a long, strong diagonal. If you like to develop that stretch, you can dorsiflex your toes up. You don't have to grab them, but if you can, that does put a little bit more of a stretch on the calves and the Achilles tendon and the bottoms of our feet. If you have a long but strong, like a dish towel or a towel, you could wrap it around your foot. Your stretchy band won't work very well for that. It might just snap up and hit you in the face. We don't want that. Other hamstring, calf, and Achilles tendon stretch. Supporting here. Take a nice long deep inhale. Fill your lungs as you stretch your spine into a long strong diagonal. You can, if you wish, dorsiflex your toe and or lasso it with a towel or an old belt works very good. Okay, now we get to do one of my favorite parts of the class, and that's called mindful breathing. Nothing is so simple that we can't mess it up. But if we practice, we will get better gradually. And just like spikes or bumps in the coronavirus, we won't get better every time. Well, with coronavirus, it'd be like that, right? But with practice, we will get better at breathing until we reach our capacity with our lung capacity. And we can even make that better by doing regular aerobic activity. Yay, team! Okay, scooch back in your chair, go to your happy place. Mine is Yellow Springs. I love my little town. Okay, I kind of miss the Glen though, but I know for right now, we're keeping it safe and simple. So I'll go there virtually in my mind. I'm gonna visit the Pine Forest. Wherever you go, relax. Close your eyes, rest your hands in your lap. Let your shoulders feel the weight, the gravity of our human condition. Relax with each breath. Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth or your nose. Exercise our imagination. Imagine in wherever your happy place is, as you breathe in through your nose, smell all the wonderful earthy smells there. As you exhale, relax, release any tension. With each breath, notice what you notice about your breathing. You can use all of your senses. As you breathe in, imagine what you're hearing in your peaceful place of joy and comfort.
Fight racism. Black Lives Matters.
is a really important issue. I'm so proud of our youthful community members who have been out exercising their right to peacefully protest. And I'm so proud of our youthful elders who wage peace every Saturday on the corner of downtown Yellow Springs. And I'm so proud of our LGBTQ community for coming out and being out and proud. I hope you keep it safe and simple. Wherever you're at, just keep moving, and see you soon.